So great teacher is a great artist, and there are as few of them as there are of any other great artist. Teaching might even be the greatest of the arts, since the medium is the human mind and spirit. That's by John Steinbeck, The Grapes of Wrath. True leaders don't create followers, they create more leaders. True and complete anarchy, anti-monarchs as non-violent because each sovereign individual recognizes the sovereignty of every other individual. Flynn Gregory. Okay, so February 2nd, 2014, 2015, 2016, we have Groundhog's Day. And why do we celebrate this stupid ass fucking holiday? It's the most irrelevant and is the stupidest. It makes absolutely no sense. And it feels like America feels like Groundhog's Day, the movie, how shit just keeps on repeating. I mean, seriously, Groundhog Day. What's the point? What is this? It's the idea is that the groundhog comes out, sees this shadow, and then we're supposed to believe that there's going to be more winter or more spring based upon this, novel fucking idea, this, you know, great discovery, whether or not a fucking groundhog sees this shadow. And really, the sun doesn't discriminate. You can just walk outside and see your own shadow, and that would say whether or not the groundhog would see a shadow. In Europe, when it was called Imbolc, which is a Celtic pagan festival, an Irish Gaelic festival, which marked the beginning of spring, or at least the halfway point from the winter solstice to the spring equinox, they celebrate it with a bear or a badger, okay? A big, strong bear or badger. I'm not sure. I don't really get excited about that, but Groundhog's Day would be a million times better if it was a black bear, brown bear, polar bear day, big bear day. You know, that would be so much better. We could go around giving each other bear hugs. But there's no fucking logic to this day whatsoever. Groundhogs are just, they're rodents. They're overweight fucking disgusting rodents. They're fucking up my yard, right? They dig little burrows into the soil, and so, you know, either they'll kill the grass or you gotta stamp it down. There's holes everywhere. Possibly could kill the grass. The foundation of my house might just collapse if they just keep on, you know, digging all these little burrows, these fucking rodents. These ugly ass, fat ass rodents, okay? They're fucking fat ass rats, okay? So fuck a groundhog. Fuck groundhog. And fuck Groundhog's Day. We're supposed to believe, you know, that fucking bullshit when it comes out and sees its shadow. The clouds isn't the only indicator of future weather. It's one of many, okay? Groundhog's Day, I'm not even curious to see Punxsutawney Phil. I don't give a shit if he sees his shadow or not. Punxsutawney, whatever his name is. The Groundhog's Day is stupid, it's pointless, it's ridiculous. Let's get rid of it. You know how to figure out if he's going to see a shadow? You just walk outside and you just see if you have your own shadow. The sun does not discriminate. If you don't have a shadow, then you're probably like a vampire or a ghost or Santa Claus or Jesus. Since all those things are really real. No, I'm just kidding you. At least groundhogs are real. Bunnies who lay chicken eggs. Now, what the fuck is that about? Okay, so let me explain Easter, okay, to all you simpletons out there. So, Jesus Christ, and don't worry, kid, he's a white man. Wink. With a hair. Wink. I said it. With a hair of wool living in the Middle East, right? He's got a hair of wool living in the Middle East. Jesus Christ, he dies for our sins. He's resurrected 3 days later. And that's the reason why on Easter we got this big-ass fucking rabbit who lays chicken eggs everywhere for the crackers and Lily White Corbin to grease up their pale faces with. Because, you know, white people just love their chicken. KFC was born in white people town. And Corbin, they just love their greasy-ass chicken and their stupid string bow ties. So Jesus Christ, this mythical character who was created by Constantine in 325 AD, was actually a huge human-sized bunny rabbit who hides plastic eggs filled with candy. Wait, what the fuck am I saying? Okay, so the point of Easter. To celebrate, Jesus Christ is finally dead and gone. Yeah, Jesus is dead, he's gone, he's off our earth. Good, it's about time. That's when a big fat white man at the Father Time, white beard, flying with 8 horses in the clouds on an old-time gigantic sled, you know, big enough to fit all the presents for the billions of boys and girls in the world. Okay, I'm getting so off track. This is not This is not his death. This is how you celebrate his birth, okay? That's how he... Okay, so let's go back to... Okay, so Jesus Christ was betrayed by Judas, who sold him for gold. He kissed him to voice his opposition to homosexuality, and that's why we celebrate Easter and Lent. Lent is the Catholic version of Passover, where we weep for 40 days for Tammuz, the Egyptian goddess. I mean, Jesus Christ. Because we know that Jesus is going to die and then resurrect. And, you know, we're not happy. We're not happy that he's going to be resurrected. The Jews had voted for him to die. That's what we wanted. It wasn't Pontius Pilate or the Romans. It was the Jews. I read the Bible. That's what it said. And going to heaven with the angels and God. And we hate that. We hate that Jesus is going to be going to heaven and with angels and with God. Hold on. If heaven is such a wonderful place, then how is Jesus dying on the cross such a huge sacrifice? Actually, when anybody dies, why are we sad when anybody dies? They're in a better place, right? So, you know, they have gone to the place of 42 virgins and a place of milk and honey and the angels and the harps and, right? Where all your parents are, they're dancing in heaven like Fred Phelps, right? Fred Phelps is dancing in heaven, right? He was pretty much by the book. He was a fundamentalist. Or the 1 million Iraqi people, they're in heaven, right? And don't be sad, because everybody's in a better place. Decomposing in a coffin 6 feet underground, a.k.a. the kingdom of heaven. So during Lent, Catholics do not eat meat, right? So 6 days you're allowed to eat meat, but not on Fridays. But you're allowed to eat fish, just the carcasses of fish. Because, I mean, seriously, like, fish isn't really a real life living creature, right? With edible muscle tissue. Fish are a vegetable, okay? Fish are vegetables. Catholics cry about the days Jesus carried the cross, and we cry for Tammuz, our sun god, the son of God, the Alpha and the Omega, for 40 days, and then just like the Babylonian, Egyptian, pagan ways, when the priest of Ishtar fucks all the religiously obedient virgins, and 9 months later during Christmas, the priests kill those babies that the virgins had, that the poor raped virgins had, and they dipped eggs in those raped virgins' babies' blood. And we do the same thing. And that's where the dyed Easter eggs come from, right? So always remember that. Always remember to dye your Easter eggs blood red, okay, children? It must be blood red. Never forget Queen Ishtar. One of the eggs to be dipped in the blood of the sacrificed children as an annual fun-filled family event. What in the fuck are you all celebrating? Okay, so I know. You all gonna say that's Egyptian mythology. Roman, Greek, Egyptian. That's just total bullshit, right? To believe their mythology. You're a real dipshit, right? If you fucking believe Egyptian gods or the Roman or Greek gods, you're so fucking stupid, right? The only god, there isn't a polytheistic. We don't believe in multiple gods. We're monotheistic. There's only one true God. And that one singular true God, his name is Jesus Christ. And the Holy Spirit. And God the Father. Okay, so there's actually like three gods, but the three is one and one is three, right? Freedom is slavery, war is peace, ignorance is knowledge. The tree of knowledge, don't you dare take a bite of that knowledge, okay? Just be dumb, obedient, and blind. Don't take a bite of that tree of knowledge. Damn it. You do not understand why dipping Easter egg bunnies in the blood of sacrificed children makes sense. Do you even know where we get this custom? Where any of these customs that we celebrate come from? Well, who gives a shit? Let's just eat Jesus Christ's body, drink his blood every week like a good, obedient cannibal. I mean, Christian, Catholic. Catholics have been getting drunk on Jesus' blood since they were 5 years old. And now the blood really isn't wine that was bought from Meijer, okay? It wasn't bought out of a box, right? And Jesus' body really isn't a cracker, a Jesus, right? It's not a little Jesus cracker. It's actually Jesus' body and his blood. And this is no bullshit. This is Catholicism. It's called transubstantiation. It's really the blood and body of Jesus Christ. So Easter and Passover are conspicuously close to each other. It's almost as if Constantine changed Passover to Easter in 325 AD. It just feels like that's what happened. I don't know. Maybe it's just me. And why does Easter and Ishtar sound so familiar, right? You have the Ishtar as the goddess. This old Egyptian goddess, Ishtar, was her name. We celebrate Easter. Ishtar, Easter. Ishtar was the Akkadian Sumerian goddess of fertility, love, and warfare. Okay, so the Akkadian Sumerian goddess of fertility, love, and warfare. And wait, did I say Akkadian? I meant East Semitic Akkadian, Assyrian, and Babylonian goddess. And remember, Babylon was the whore of Revelations. It was because of Babylon, that city of whores, that's why God's going to kill everybody and everything and everywhere, right? Just like Noah's flood. Which comes out of the ancient epic of Gilgamesh. So Uruk is where Ishtar is worshipped, and Ishtar is an equal counterpart to the Sumerian Inanna, and Ishtar is the cognate for the Northwest Semitic Aramean goddess Astarte. This year Easter lands on Hitler's birthday, aka 420, April the 20th, so you can either celebrate Easter by murdering 6 million Jews, and actually I heard it was like 10 million total. You can dip Easter eggs in the blood of children had by virgins who are raped by priests, or you can be like Bob Marley, get high all day. It's 4 fucking 20. Go to a music festival, smoke some Kentucky Bluegrass Kush, John Robert Boone's hybrid. So the ancient Egyptians, right? They didn't allow their Ishtar. Not only did the ancient so fucked up, but the ancient Egyptians, not only did they allow their Ishtar priests to rape their virgin daughters, kill their babies, and then dip the eggs in their blood, but they also would weep for Tammuz for 40 days. So weeping for Tammuz, this is Lent. This is what the Catholics call Lent. So Tammuz was Ishtar's son slash lover, and he died. He was killed by a wild boar. Became a god, and then we weep for Tammuz for 40 days until the last day when the Ishtar priests start their sickening sacrifices and rapes. All the while we eat a big Sunday ham, which is symbolic of the pig that murdered Tammuz. Okay, so Easter comes from, you know, the same pagan heathens that the Bible condemns, but Catholicism was universal, so they had to capture all these pagan practices, and so that's how they were able to get Easter Sunday, right? So it used to be called Passover. The Jews have been celebrating spring with Passover for years. And the Catholics decided to go a different route. So, Babylon the Whore, that's Revelations, right? Legend has it that Queen Ishtar was born out of heaven in a giant egg, landing into the Euphrates River at sunrise on the first Sunday after the vernal equinox. So, Queen Ishtar was born the first Sunday after the vernal equinox. That's spring. So, the spring equinox, she was born the first Sunday afterwards. So, they're going to have a celebration for Queen Ishtar for landing, you know, she born out of heaven in a giant egg, landed in the Euphrates River at sunrise on the first Sunday after the vernal equinox. Ishtar then busted out and turned a bird into an egg-laying rabbit. Who knows why she did that? To honor this event, pagan sun worshippers would go out early in the morning and face to the east and watch their sun god arise over the horizon before having a mass in which the priests of Easter, Ishtar, would sacrifice 3-month-year-old human infants and take the eggs of Easter and dye them in the blood of the sacrificed infants. The blood-red-colored Easter eggs would later hatch on December 25th, the same day her son Tammuz, the reincarnate sun god, would be born. So how convenient. Easter married her son Tammuz, who was by legend the reincarnated sun god. Tammuz went pig hunting and was gored to death by a wild boar, and that's why pagans eat ham on Easter. So when you're eating Easter ham, just understand it's because of the weeping of Tammuz. You know, the 40 days, he was 40 years old. Tammuz was 40 years old. Pagans fast one day for each of the years that he had lived leading up to Easter. And then Easter is a big fucking celebration, right? So the mourning for Tammuz actually is listed in the Bible in Ezekiel 8, chapter 8, verse 14 to 15. Then he brought me to the door of the gate of the Lord's house, which was toward the north, and behold, there sat women weeping for Tammuz. Then he said unto me, hast thou seen this, O son of man? Turn thee yet again, and thou shalt see greater abominations than these. So the weeping of Tammuz starts the beginning of the summer solstice. It actually says that she was born right in the spring. So there'd be Easter. That's probably her birth was, you know, celebrated. And then 40 days of weeping. Then the summer solstice. And the time of mourning in the ancient Near East as in the Aegean. The Babylonians marked the decline in daylight hours and onset of killing summer heat and drought with a six-day funeral for the god. Recent discoveries reconfirm him as an annual life, death, rebirth deity. Tammuz is the name of the Sumerian god of food and vegetation. Agriculture, also worshipped in the later Mesopotamian states of Akkad, Assyria, and Babylonia. Tammuz was a Sumerian god of food, vegetation, and agriculture. So, during Lent, make sure you understand that, you know, you're looking at the stations of the cross and you think you're crying for Jesus, but Jesus was made up. And so really you're crying for Tammuz, who's this weird, you know, guy who got murdered by a wild boar. And when you eat the ham, you're eating, you know, the wild boar that had killed Tammuz.